met a Pompolo, aka Tompolo.
Yes. Yeah, go and tell her. Wait.
The lies of your deputy governor and other your prominent leaders in that place, are aware of what is happening currently. Because if they are not part of this plot, no Ijaw youths will be abandoned to go publicly making this inciting statements and unguided statements that they are going to kill the Shekri, they are going to burn down all the oil factories in our homelands. Few days ago here, Tompolo, a man that we all know, was very instrumental in burning and destroying all our communities, killing our innocent people, kidnapping our people on the IC, on the waterways, celebrated his 50th birthday a few days ago here. You can see that because of the love of the Chekri people, because of our civilized ways, some of our people forgot about the past, and we're on the streets of Warri jubilating and celebrating Tompolo on his 50th birthday with this same Ijaw youth. Where is he now? Since all these things happening, can this thing happen without their notice? Without his notice? They have all remained silent. They have said nothing. You know why? Because they are the brain behind this. The deputy governor that has a responsibility to make sure that where he claimed to come from is at peace, is silent in the whole of all these issues. The Shekiri has given enough to the Jaws. The Shekiri don't deserve this. Few months ago here, an Ijaw man was made the Warri North local government area against stiff opposition from reasonable Shekiri. Some Shekiri in Warri North, they traded off that local government seat to an Ijaw man. They did it. They traded off that local government thinking that there will be peace between them and the Ijaws. What is happening now? When the Ijaw man was sworn in, the first place he visited was Tompolo's place. And now look at what is happening. The Ijaws are issuing threats to our people in our own land that they are to evacuate, because Chevron have refused to yield to their illegality. I'm not going to take much time. We have also resolved to take appropriate actions to defend our fatherland, to defend our people, and to protect our collective heritage as a people. Since the Jaws have decided that our peaceful disposition is for cowardice, I know they too will not want a repeat of the Warri crisis, because each and every one of us remember how that crisis ended. We have tried to live in peace with them. We have made all kinds of overtures, kind gestures, all in the name of peace. But yet on daily basis, our people have been harassed. Our people have been intimidated. But this is the last time such a thing will happen. If the Jaws are not comfortable, if they are not willing to obey law and order in our land, if they are not willing to recognize our title to those lands, if they feel uncomfortable, they should quietly relocate back to Gbaran in Bayelsa State, where they migrated from, instead of causing problems to us here. And finally, I'm using this opportunity to appeal to the federal government of Nigeria. Under Section 42 of the Criminal Code, it is a criminal offense for anybody to begin to make statements that will promote communal war. They just have been making these threats. And the platform which they are using to make this threat is one a well-known platform called Baramato Voice. They seem to also have maybe a television station or I don't know. But that station needs to be closed down. The Baramatu voice needs to be closed down. Because much as they have the right to freedom of information or expression, they cannot begin to use their platform to promote violence, illegality, and threat. The government needs to do the needful now. Our people were massacred and killed in the past because the government refused to take adequate step. Right now, we have made up our mind that we will not fold our arms while customized tenants or strangers begin to issue threat to our people. We are promising and we are saying that should anything happen to any Shekiri person in their communities on the waterways, we will not sit down kindly and take it lightly as it were before. The jaws, they are also human beings. They feel pains. They die too. So if they are issuing threat to our people that they are going to kill, they are going to maim, they should also know that by beating that drum of war, the outcome will be for all of us. And so I am calling on the federal government under President Muhammadu Buhari not to sit by and allow these miscreants trouble the peace of the Niger Delta. The COVID-19 has brought a lot of economic woes on this country. Nigeria needs the Niger Delta to be at peace for it to be able to survive economically. The level of unemployment in our land is so massive. Recently, the statistics revealed that about 33% or 37% thereabout of unemployment in Nigeria. If these people are allowed to destroy these oil facilities, and if Chevron Nigeria Limited decide to relocate our risk country, the entire country will put into a state of mess. This issue is not just about the Shekiri people. This issue is about the survival of our country. And also, I'm calling on the executive governor of Delta State, His Excellency Governor Ato Ifeanyi Okowa, not to sit by in Asaba and allow the deputy governor and his yeoman, who has a vested interest in this issue, to throw the entire state back to the days of the Warri Crisis, where the whole state was thrown into a state of anarchy, where there was bloodshed everywhere. As the number one chief security officer of Delta State, Your Excellency, you have the duty and responsibility to wake up to this challenge. You cannot sit back. Why your deputy governor, his people are on top of boats, threatening the peace of this state, threatening to cause mayhem. It is your responsibility as our dear governor to make sure that all those that are doing this are brought to book. Because if it is not done, it's going to continue to create a precedent that anybody can just wake up any day and issue threats and nothing will happen. We cannot continue to pamper criminals.